Check out this CSS code from Coca-Cola's website. Looks intense. Before you will be able to write CSS code like this, you first need to understand the basic building blocks that make up a single CSS statement. All CSS begins with what is known as a rule set. A rule set is made up of two parts: a selector, which is the code that selects the HTML elements that you want to style, and a declaration block, which is the code that describes the styles you want to apply to said HTML. Declarations are the lines of code written inside the curly braces. As an example, let's look at this simple, unstyled web page. On the left, I have my web page, and on the right, I have my code for the web page. Remember how the head of the page is used for the meta information about the site? Style is one of the pieces of information that goes inside the head. Anything that goes inside these style tags is CSS. For this example, I'll start by typing P, followed by some braces, then color, colon, blue, and ending with a semicolon. This P is our selector. It is telling the browser, I want to select all the P tags, or paragraph tags, on the page. The code inside the curly braces is our declaration. It reads color, colon, blue, semicolon. In this line, color is the property we want to change, and blue is the value we want to pass to it. This is how CSS works for every property. You pass it a value, like blue, and the value describes how the browser should render the property for the element. Properties are always written in plain English, and they identify a feature of an HTML element that you want to change. So let's see what this page looks like after I add this CSS. I'll just save, and let me go refresh my page, and voila, there you go. When I added the CSS to the web page, the color of the font and the paragraph tags changed to blue.